It's also hashtag Blue Friday here on New Jersey 101.5. I want to introduce our honoree for today. His name is Sergeant Dave Schultz, and he's with the Hamilton Police Department. Dave, thanks for coming in. How are you?
Thanks, Bill. Thanks for having me.
So, Dave, you've got a serious cause. Your son Ryan has Duchenne's, and for people that don't know, it's a rare form of muscular dystrophy, very serious condition. But now for the last 10 years, now he's 12.
He is,
right?
Yes.
And for the last 10 years, you have been running this charity, Ryan's Quest. And I'll tell you something. I was really honored that you asked me to MC this year. I'm happy to be a part of it and just help this great cause. It's like you just, there's so many causes out there. But this one, you joined with a partner with the NYPD, right?
Yeah, a good friend of mine, Rob Capolongo.
Now, his son
also has it. Yes.
And now just tell me quickly about Ryan's condition. It's treatable. Like, where are we with Duchenne's disease?
So Duchenne is the most common lethal, fatal genetic disorder diagnosed in children today. There's about 20,000 children each year that will be diagnosed with Duchenne.
I didn't realize it was that common.
Yes, it is. Generally, what happens is every muscle in your body will slowly deteriorate as you get older. And currently, you know, the lifespan for a child diagnosed with Duchenne now would be in their late 20s. So it's a very serious and fatal disorder. So that's why we do what we do to help, you know, try to change the outcome a little bit.
Yeah. And how is he doing? How are spirits?
Ryan's doing very good. Very happy kid. Big Giants fan.
So he skipped the Super Bowl.
Tough year
for the Giants. Yeah, it was.
He just wants to be a normal kid and do what other kids do. And he's a great, smart boy.
Yeah. Well, I certainly appreciate what you do. And, this idea that we talk about hashtag Blue Friday, I mean, it's just kind of the other side of police officers and, you know, law enforcement. I mean, you've still got your job to do every day. So I'm going to put the uniform on. Let me ask you about that for a minute. I'll touch on this maybe a little tomorrow night at the event. It's sold out, though, so no one can, right? It's too late to get tickets.
It is, yes. We have 600 attendees coming tomorrow
night.
Wow.
Do you pre-sell for next year, or you don't know yet?
No, we haven't done that.
Right, haven't done that yet?
No, not yet.
Should think about that. It's, you know, I mean, 600 people, how fast did it sell out? It was sold out before we even booked you to come on.
Yeah, it goes pretty quick. You know, it's a popular event. We're very fortunate to have the support, you know, from everybody. But we try to put on a great event so everyone has a good time.
And it's at the Hyatt 7 to midnight tomorrow.
Yes.
The Hyatt
Princeton. Tomorrow night in Princeton.
But tell me about just working as a cop these days. Have you seen over the past few years, are things settling down? I mean, we kind of went through this time where it was just so hostile and negative with the media attitude toward police officers. Do you see it? Has it changed a little bit? Or not really?
I don't think so. Not really. I think it has its ups and downs. You know, certain things will happen, but I just think it's just the way it's going to be right now for a while, you know.
How hard is it to balance just a day-to-day life as a cop, especially as a police sergeant? And then run the charity, and then you have a family.
It's all about time management, and you know, a lot of good help, a lot of good, you know, supporters and volunteers and board members to help, you know, really keep it running.
So let me ask you, Dave, how can people help? They can't go to the event now; it's sold out. But there'll be another one next year. Where do they go? Is there a website they should go to?
We do. Our website is ryansquest.org.
Okay.
And we have information about Duchenne, about the charity. If they would like to donate, of course, it can all be done on our website.
And where does the money is spent on research?
Yeah. We've contributed to everywhere from, you know, researchers in the university setting to small startup companies to doctors and hospitals that do research, you know, contributing money to them. And we've even helped some families that are enrolled in clinical trials who need help, you know, getting the family back and forth to the trial site because it becomes very expensive. So we've done a little bit of everything. I consider us more or less the bridge to help, you know, get them over to where they need to be. So it's our part of this that we can contribute.
So I'll have this information put on our website, nj1015.com, and we'll make sure that people have that easy button to click if they want to donate, if they want to help. And, you know, God bless you and your family. Thank you, Dave, for what you're doing. And I'm looking forward to tomorrow night.
Thank you, Bill. I'm glad you're coming.